and destroyed. It is through the process of mananam. Mananam means intense reflection on what has been taught by the guru with the aid of scriptures, with the aid of logical reasoning, through the experiences of elders, the aptavakyas of elders. I destroy all the doubts in my mind so that doubt-free knowledge can take deep roots in my mind. That is the second step. And the final step in stabilizing that knowledge is nididhyasanam, which is constant contemplation on what has already been learnt and understood, so that I will remove any habitual notions like I am the body, I am the mind, I am suffering today, and I am happy today. All those external disturbances are rooted out through the process of nididhyasana. So the acharya, having prayed for the prerequisites, saying, bless me with the ability to do this process of shravanam, mananam and nididhyasanam as well, so that I will understand that my real nature is not this perishable body, but I am the immortal consciousness. So that is the prayer. And not only that, bless me with swantametad ruchi yutam manisham nirvikalpe samadav. Bless me with the ruchi to abide in that knowledge that has been acquired through shravanam, mananam and nididhyasanam. In the state of nirvikalpa samadhi, let my mind completely abide as that Atman itself. Bless me with a ruchi or an intense taste or an inclination to abide as that. And this abidance leads us into the final state of Atmanishta, Brahmanishta, Jivan Muktihi, or many other epithets that have been used by our Shastras. Let me abide as that is the prayer. And in closing, the Acharya says, O Sharada Devi, who is seated on the throne of the Sri Chakra Yantra, on the beautiful temple on the banks of the Tunga River at Sringeri, O such a great mother, O compassionate mother, O ocean of compassion, you must please give me all of this that I've asked for, because nobody else but you can give me this, O great one. Vidyam Shuddhancha Buddhim O Kamala Jadayite, quickly, right now, without any further delay, forgive me for all my omissions and commissions, and bless me with Chitta Shuddhi, purity of mind, and bless me with Atma Vidya right now. So that is the prayer. And like we set out at the beginning, this is one of the most comprehensive prayers that a sadhaka can incorporate in his daily life among the rest of his prayers. It is highly recommended by famous teachers and gurus that a sadhaka can incorporate this Kamala Jadayita Ashtakam for daily parayana, because it asks for all that is required for a sadhaka, including purity of mind, purity of thoughts, ability to do karma, the health to perform that karma, and a long life to perform all those required obligatory duties. The prerequisites for Vedanta Vichara, the process of Vedanta Vichara, and the final abidance and Atmanishta. All that is required for a sadhaka has been asked for in 8 short verses, 8 beautiful verses by His Holiness Sri Satchitananda Shiva Abhinava Narasimha Bharati Mahaswami, with our pranams and prayers at His lotus feet and at the lotus feet of Sharadamba of Sringeri. Let us all pray for Chitta Shuddhi and for Atmajnanam. Om Tat Sat.